Hi there again, class of 2025 students and parents. So what are some of the problems that you may run into when you file your FAFSA that I want you to start thinking about right now? And when you're trying to decide whether you're going to do the FAFSA, most of you will, or whether I'll file the FAFSA for you. There are some things you need to consider about this new FAFSA. You may have done the old one before and think you can handle it, but this one's different. So you're going to have to be careful. Let me update you on some of the concerns, some of the things that have tripped others up. But here are some of the things that we've seen as problems this year. Here are the major things. How's that? These are the major things. First of all, the FAFSA was updated last year in 23-24 for the 25-25 FAFSA. Okay, now we're going to 25-26, which I might tell you is based on 2023 income parents, not 2024. A lot of you don't know that. So you want to get that 23 return settled or corrected and updated, whatever you have to do on that. There were many issues, problems for those who did their youth's FAFSA themselves, you know, did it themselves. About 25 to 30% of people ended up having to call the feds up, and they didn't get great help on the phones. I helped a lot of people like that, actually from across the country, who responded to these videos. 4% of people, it's estimated, maybe 5, were not even able to get financial aid and just gave up and their kids are home because the FAFSA system was so difficult to navigate. What's so hard about it? Why? The form is easier, but the process is confusing and illogical to many. Man, it's like the more logical you are, the more confused you are. First of all, there were username and password issues. Okay? And that's why the last video advised you to get your username and password early. Next, we were unable to determine, or families weren't able to determine, who the right contributors were. There need to be adult contributors. And there's a lot of subjectivity in our families. It could be a mixed house. It could be a house where, you know, two different homes are intermingled. It could be there's only one parent and the other parent separated, but around all the time. Do both parents have to be listed? These are all questions that are confusing. And if you don't have a clear understanding of that, this new process, you won't get out of it. You'll be stuck. Unable to coordinate the submission of all sections between student and contributors. Oh my God, that's a huge one. Students were able to do their section. They thought they were done, but the contributors never did their section, or the student never told the contributor. So therefore the FAFSA wasn't really complete. And finally, there's a general misunderstanding of questions on this FAFSA. Even though it's shorter, there's still some areas where there's some confusion and ambiguity about how things are to be answered. So that's a taste of some of the issues that you could have if you do the FAFSA. Once again, we'll be calling for data sheets in November. Just watch your email very closely. And you'll be able to know how we could, you'll be able to get us to help you anyway by filing your FAFSA or help you to file your FAFSA. There'll be a small donation to do that, but I think you may agree it's well worth it once you get through the process. Okay, thank you all very much. God bless you. Remember to like and subscribe. If these kind of videos, you're finding them informative, I need you to click like and to subscribe to be sure that you get notified when we drop videos. The like is to help increase the reach of our videos across this great nation. God bless you. Bye-bye now.